And the next talk is also related to cancer, and Professor Gu, he will speak about diagnosis, preparation, and in vivo and in vitro anti-tumor effects.
Who is it? Oh, this one? Good afternoon, everyone. I'm happy to introduce our recent research results about self-assembled copolycurcumin nanoparticles. You know, curcumin is a diaryl heptaloid, which is the principal curcuminoid of turmeric. Turmeric is one family of the ginger, one member of the ginger family. You know, curcumin can inhibit proliferation of different kinds of cancer, such as breast cancer, lung cancer, colon cancer, and prostate cancer. It can also be a chemosensitizer and can effectively reverse cancer multi-drug resistance. Although curcumin has good anti-cancer effects in vitro, but its in vivo anti-cancer activity is very poor. This is because curcumin is almost water insoluble and very poorly solubility at a physiological pH. And its elimination half-life time is just less than 10 minutes. So in order to overcome these shortcomings, we designed and synthesized the biotin PCD nanoparticles. The polycurcumin PCDA is obtained by condensation polymerization of curcumin and diacyl dipropionic acid. And the biotin PCDA can be obtained by esterization of PCDA and biotin PEG. And the biotin PEG PCDA nanoparticles can be easily propelled by emulsion shown evaporation method. This table lists the molecular weight and the molecular weight distribution index of the prepared polymers. And the solubility of biotin PEG PCDA in phosphate sulfur buffer solution at pH 7.4 is investigated by observing the UV absorbance change. We can find the UV spectra of a biotin PEG PCDA nanoparticle PCDA don't change in three hours, but in contrast, the UV spectra of curcumin changes very fast in just 15 minutes. So the biotin PEG PCDA is stable at pH 7.4, but curcumin is unstable. The biotin PEG PCDA nanoparticles can be prepared I just said a simple method, emulsion, solvent evaporation. And you can see the biotin PEG PCD nanoparticles is 125 nanometer in hydrodynamic diameter and minus 12.8 MV in zeta potential, and it has a high drug loading of 27%, higher than that of the curcuminated myosos. The nanoparticles are spheric. These fix the dynamic laser scan scattering patterns and gel permeation tomography curves of biotin PEG PCD nanoparticles in PBS at different concentrations of glutathione. You can see less than 10 micromolar of glutathione, the nanoparticles, the size of nanoparticles don't change, and then the GPS, GPC curves almost don't change. It means the volume it didn't it don't. It doesn't degradable. So at a high concentration of glutathione, about 5 millimolar, about this is the intracellular concentration of glutathione. The nanoparticles, the size nanoparticles changes, and then the GPC curves changes. It means the nanoparticles disassemble, and degradation occurs. These figures are the LC mass spectra you can find. At the biotin PEG PCDA in PBS with 5 millimolar glutathione and 100 unit esterase, you can find the degradation species. One of the degradation species is curcumin. We also studied the cellular uptake of a biotin PEG PCD nanoparticles is investigated by a flow cytometry. We found the intracellular fluorescence in HeLa cells is significantly higher than in HeLa cells incubated with biotin PEG PCD nanoparticles. Is higher than that incubated with PEG-PCDA, PEG-PCDA nanoparticles. And when addition of free biotin in the incubation medium, the intracellular fluorescence decreases. This indicates that the uptake of biotin PEG PCD nanoparticles by HeLa cells is mediated by biotin receptor. The cytotoxicity against the AMT6 in the HeLa cells is determined by MTT. You can find the cytotoxicity of biotin PEG PCD nanoparticles is lower than that of Copolycurcumin. The fluorescence of biotin PEG PCD nanoparticles is not strong enough to monitor its biodistribution. So we use Dr. Robinson as a fluorescence probe to study biodistribution. We found the when we study when we after intravenous injection of dox or dox-loaded PEG PCD nanoparticles or dox biotin PEG PCD nanoparticles, about 9 days we harvest the organs from the MT6 tumor bearing Kunming mice, and we found the free dox is primarily accumulated in liver, but for the dox-loaded biotin PEG PCD nanoparticles, the nanoparticles are many accumulated in the tumor, and the amount of the nanoparticles increase with the time. We also studied the in vivo anti-tumor activity of a biotin PEG PCD nanoparticles by using a xenograft MT6 tumor bearing Kunming mice. We found the biotin PEG PCD nanoparticles has the highest tumor inhibition rate. It's up to 79%. These figures are HE tuner KI67, CT61, and VHF and Cox2 images of the tumor samples harvested from the tumor mice after drug administration. From this fix, we can find the biotin PEG PCD nanoparticles can if this is about biotin PEG PCD nanoparticles can effectively inhibit proliferation and induce apoptosis and inhibit angiogenesis. This is why the nanoparticles has excellent in vivo anti-tumor activity. Yeah. Okay. From this fix, we found the biotin PEG PCD nanoparticles is almost no toxic to heart, brain, and liver, and kidney. So, summary of our nanoparticles. Our nanoparticles have a good water solubility, and high stability, and excellent in vivo anti-tumor activity. That's all. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Question, please.
Hi. I'm also working on curcumin nanoparticles, and so How did you administer the polymer nanoparticles to mice and at which concentration? Thanks. What was it? IV injection or
IV
oral?
Injection, yeah.
And the concentration of curcumin, the equivalent curcumin concentration?
The concentration? I use saturated solution of the nanoparticles.
The concentration?
Concentration? About maybe my microgram per millimeter.
One microgram. Thank you.
Is there any other question from the audience? That's not the case, and thanks to speak again. And the next talk, the